know, I'm not too much of a fan of Shoshin. I don't think it does too great of a job of conditioning, keeping his coat shiny and tangle-free. So I thought I would throw some products together and try to create my own recipe. So this is what I came up with. I threw these products together and surprisingly, they worked really well. I usually spray this all over his body after our rides, and the next day, dirt is usually easier to brush off. His coat feels a lot softer, and it has a slight sheen to it. Of course, feel free to change up the ratios between the products. Maybe add some more water, maybe add some more oils. Feel free to put your own spin on it with different scented oils and whatnot. If you try my recipe or try out your own recipe and put a different spin on it, please let me know in the comments down below and tell me what you think or what you use differently in your recipe. So let's get into the video. So our first ingredient in the coat conditioner is baby oil. And this particular one has aloe vera and vitamin E, so that makes it perfect for moisturizing and skin soothing. And if it's gentle enough for babies, it's definitely gentle enough for our horses with sensitive skin. Next ingredient is witch hazel. Fun fact, witch hazel is one of the main ingredients in Soar No More, so it can also be used as a liniment. A few more benefits include that it can remove stains, relieve itches, and it is also antiseptic. Next is coconut oil. It has a great shelf life. It's not petroleum or silicon based, so it's really easily absorbed into the skin. Also, it helps to soothe insect bites. When added to your horse's food, it can also help to entice picky eaters, and it's a cool source of energy so it won't make your horses hot, and is non-greasy and great for sensitive skin. Next is argan oil. It's been kind of a trend lately. You can use it on your own hair, skin, nails, face, and that's what I do, so I thought I would add it to the recipe. It also is very moisturizing, helps to soothe rashes or irritation, helps to heal bug bites and also little infections that your horse may have. Next is glycerin, which is a thick and moisturizing liquid. It helps the skin to retain water, reduce the look of scars, and it's non-toxic. It can hopefully help heal your nips from turnout a little faster. Tea tree oil is next on the list. One of the most common uses is for lice prevention. It's really helpful for the buggy seasons and during turnout to keep those critters away. Also, for added bug protection, feel free to add in some citronella oil as well, because that is one of the main ingredients in fly spray. Also is antiseptic, so it can help heal and clean minor wounds. It soothes sunburns, relieves itch, so hopefully if you spray it in their manes and tails, you can then avoid your horses rubbing their manes and tails out. As well, it is antifungal, so it's perfect in the muddy seasons when rain rot is very common. So once you've got all those ingredients, you can go ahead and grab any spray bottle and we can start putting it all together. Thank you.
And that is how you make the coat conditioner. I know, super easy, right? But just give it another good shake before you spray it on your ponies. I've definitely noticed that Ralph's coat has a nicer shine and is more moisturized. So look forward to the same results when you use it.